morning to all of you. So yesterday I have told you about the meaning of the solution of the equation. What is the meaning of the solution? Solution means those values of x and y which satisfies the given equation. That means while we put those values of x and y in the equation, we'll get the two sides, right hand side and left hand side equal. On the basis of this definition of the solution, we were doing exercise 4.2. Two questions we have finished. Let us start with question number third. Third question of exercise 4.2 we are going to start with. Third question is, check whether following are the solution of the equation x minus 2y is equal to 4 or no. First point is 0, 2. So what the question is, we want to check whether 0, 2 is the solution of the given equation x minus 2y equal to 4 or no. How to check? Let us take the left hand side. Left hand side is equal to x minus 2y. Replacing the value, I'm going to replace x by 0. The first number stands for 0 and the second number of the ordered pair, it stands for y. So you'll take it to be 2. So this is 0 minus 4, getting it to be minus 4, mark it to be 1. So after solving left hand side, you are getting it to be minus 4. So let us solve right hand side. Right hand side is 4. This is equation number 2. So from 1 and 2, you can conclude from 1 and 2. That left hand side is not equals to right hand side. This implies 0, 2 is not the solution of given equation. 0, 2 is not the solution of given equation. When you are putting the values of the variables x and y in the given equation, what you are getting? You are getting the two sides not equal to, they are not equal to each other. So we conclude that this 0, 2 is not a solution of the given equation, right? So I'm going to take its fourth part. In fourth part, the ordered pair is like root 2, 4 root 2, right? So this is your x and this is y. Let us take the left hand side of the equation. Equation is same. So this is x minus 2y. Let us replace the values. X is root 2 minus 2 into y is 4 root 2. First number of the ordered pair stands for x and second number of the ordered pair undoubtedly stand for y. So this is root 2 minus 8 root 2. And in 8th standard, we learn it that whenever we have to do the operations, right? In 9th standard, first chapter, we learn it that whenever we have to do the operations of irrational numbers, if the number in the root is the same, then you can add or subtract. So we can do the calculations, match up the sign, plus minus minus. This is 8 root 2. This is 1 root 2. So 8 root 2 may say 1 root 2 gaya, you will be getting 7 root 2. And which number is the bigger one? 8 root 2. So sign is of minus. Equation number 1. So after solving left hand side, you are getting it to be minus 7 root 2. So let us see the right hand side. Right hand side, we all know it is 4. Equation number 2. So from 1 and 2, left hand side, this is not equals to right hand side. Therefore, this implies root 2, 4 root 2 is not the solution of given equation. This is not the solution of given equation. Had the side been identical, it would have been the solution. But as the sides are not identical, so we say that the given ordered pair is not going to be the solution of given equation. So rest of the parts are your homework. Let us start with fourth question of the exercise. Question number 4. Fourth question we are going to start with, but the question is find k. We have to find the value of k. It is given if x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1 is solution of equation 2x plus 3y equals to k. So what is given to us? What we want to find actually in this question? We want to find the value of this k, unknown k, with which condition? What is given to us? X is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1. It is given to be the solution of the equation. So, you know, if two variables, one is x, another is y, in an ordered pair, is the solution of an equation, then for that ordered pair, the left-hand side and the right-hand side will definitely be equal. So because yesterday we have done the meaning of the solution, that solution is that ordered pair which satisfies the given equation. So how we'll write? Let us see. As x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1 is ko number 1 bol do. Solution of 1. Therefore, putting x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 1, the two sides will remain equal. As it is solution, so as I'm replacing x by 2 and y by 1, whatever I'm getting on the left hand side, I don't know what will be the right hand side, but they should be equal according to given, you can say according to the definition of the solution, right? So let us solve it. You will be having 4 plus 3 is equal to k. So k comes out to be 7. This is the answer for k. So you're having k is equal to 7, right? So this is all about exercise 4.2, in which we have learned the meaning of the solution, its application in the questions. And let us start with the next topic of the chapter, that is graphical representation. Graphical representation of linear equation in two variables. Graphical representation of linear equation in two variables. That, you know, whatever mathematical expressions are with us, whether we are saying the complementary angle, the supplementary angle, whether you can say 1 as integer, you can say 2 by 3 a fraction. Everything has some geometrical significance in mathematics. Everything has some geometrical interpretation in mathematics. Similarly, linear equation in two variables, it is also having some graphical representation. So let us see what that graphical representation is and what we have to learn about it. You know, when you will draw the graph of this equation, earlier you did the graph learned in chapter 3 that we are plotted the points on in two dimensional plane. Hame aise points plot karne sikhe the. This is 2 3, say it be 1 3, like this. So we have plotted the point. Whenever we are working in two dimensional, we have to plot the points. Hame points plot karne. So as linear equation in two variables, it is in two variables. That means for drawing its graph, what we will need points. Hamare paas points honge tabhi hum iska graph draw kar payenge. Reason being, jahan pe do variables aage, usko graphically representation karne ke liye, usko graph pe lane ke liye, we need what? We need points. So iske liye hame points chahiye honge. Right? So how to get those points? Again, you are getting the solution same way. Solutions will be the points. Graph draw karne ke liye points kahan se aayenge? Hum solutions find karenge. Kaise find karte hain solution? X ki value put ki, y ki value aa gayi. So let it be 1, 2. Pehla point ho gaya. X ki value put ki, y ki value aa gayi. Let it be 2, 3. X ki value put ki, y ki value aagi, that let it be 3, 4. So what I want to convey, that whenever you are going to draw the graph of the linear equation in two variable, you will need points. And what, how you will create those points द सेम वे यू आर क्रिएटिंग द सॉल्यूशंस ऑफ द इक्वेशन. उसी तरह से जैसे आप इक्वेशन का सॉल्यूशन फाइंड करते हो, जो सॉल्यूशंस होंगे वही वो वाले पॉइंट्स हो जाएंगे विच आर टू बी प्लॉटेड, जिनको हमने प्लॉट करना है, राइट. सो आफ्टर प्लॉटिंग द पॉइंट यू विल गेट द पिक्चर ऑफ द ग्राफ. लेट आई एम मार्किंग इट टू बी हियर लाइक दिस. इट कैन बी लाइक दिस ग्राफ की पिक्चर. It can be like any way. So after drawing the picture of the graph, you will get the picture like this. So what it means? Graph of the linear equation in two variables is always a straight line in any direction. It can be slanting like this. It can be straight like this. It can be like this. It can be in any direction, but it will always be a straight line. So we will get a straight line as a graph of the linear equation in two variables. So we need points that are the solutions. They are to be plotted on the graph paper, and what picture you are going to get, you will get a straight line. So this is called graphical representation of the linear equation in two variables. Graphical representation of the linear equation in two variables, right? चलिए यहां से कुछ एक पॉइंट्स मैंने डिड्यूस करने हैं जो कि मैंने आपको लिखवाने. देखो इधर मैंने आपको बताया कि आप ग्राफ के पॉइंट्स क्या आएंगे, सॉल्यूशन. जो आप सॉल्यूशंस निकालते हो वैसे ही पॉइंट्स निकलेंगे जैसे आप सॉल्यूशंस निकालते हो. इसका मतलब एक चीज आपने याद रखनी है, एवरी सॉल्यूशन ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशन इन टू वेरिएबल्स lies on its graph. Linear equation का जो graph होगा उसके सारे solution उस graph पे बैठे होंगे, क्योंकि solution से ही तो graph बना है. तो इसका मतलब solution will lie on the graph. Or in the other way we can say the points on the graph will be the solutions of the equation. Vice versa, that means if I am saying that every solution lies on the graph, on the other hand I am saying if a point lies on the graph, that is going to be the solution of the equation. So these two points, whatever I am writing, they are going to be very very important when we will do the questions. So this is all about the graphical representation of the linear equation in two variables. You have to remember it is always a straight line. We need points to draw it, and those points will be the solution. That means solution lies on the graph. That means the point which lies on the graph will be the solution of the equation. Is it okay up to this? Because this is going to be important for the next exercise. Right? Is it okay? Anshia, Jia, Anshia, JJ sisters, जो बच्चे ज्यादा आके क्वेश्चन पूछते हैं, कईयों को तो है ही नहीं, हम पीरियड लगा लें. दीपाली, राइट, दे नेवर गेट एबसेंट. धैर्य का मन करता है तो आ जाता है, नहीं करता तो नहीं आता. चलो एनी हाउ, सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द डेफिनेशन पार्ट ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 4.3. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद एक्सरसाइज 4.3. स्टार्ट. First question, 4.3 exercise, draw the graph of the following. I would like to take it second part, 4.3, question number first, second part. Exercise 4.3. Question number first. Second part is x minus y is equal to 2. We need to draw its graph. And before drawing graph, I know what kind of picture I'm going to get. I will be getting a straight line. This is part obvious. This is, you can say, 100% sure that I'm going to get a straight line. Right? Now to draw graph, we need points. And to find points, we need to find solutions. And with those solution, we will make a table. Let me tell you how. First, put. अच्छा एक मिनट पहले मुझे टेबल ही बनाने दो, फिर मैं आपको एक चीज बताऊं. इस टेबल में यू विल पुट द सॉल्यूशंस, दैट मींस वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स एंड कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग वैल्यूज ऑफ वाई. फर्स्ट जब भी आपने कोई ग्राफ ड्रॉ करना है ना, एक चीज याद रखना, मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम, कभी कभी ऐसा नहीं भी होगा बट मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम यू विल हैव एक्स जीरो एंड वाई जीरो. दैट मींस एक्स को जीरो लेके जो वाई की वैल्यू आ रही है और वाई को जीरो लेके जो एक्स की वैल्यू आ रही है वो तो आपने लेना ही लेना. सो आई एम पुटिंग एक्स जीरो. सो एक्स को आपने जीरो पुट किया इन द इक्वेशन, यू आर गेटिंग वाई टू बी माइनस टू. पहला सोल्यूशन इसमें पुट कर दे, x zero y minus two. First solution that I have placed it in the table. Second, हमेशा मुझे y को zero लेना है. Put y zero. You will be having x minus zero is equal to two. X is equal to two. X is two. Y zero x two. This is the second order pair. Second solution. बाकी जो तीन अब हमने at least four values लिखनी है. बाकी आप कुछ भी ले सकते हो. I am taking x to be one. Put x is equal to 1. So 1 minus y equal to 2. Minus y is equal to 2. Minus 1. Minus y is equal to 1. So y is equal to minus 1. While taking x is equal to 1, I am getting y equal to minus 1. See the calculations. While taking x is equal to 1, I am getting y equal to minus 1. This is the third. Fourth one. Put x is equal to 2. Put x is equal to 2. You will be having 2 minus y is equal to 2, minus y is equal to 2 minus 2, x is equal to 2 तो already हो चुका है ना, तो हम कोई और point लेते हैं. Let us take x is equal to 3, so this is 3 minus y is equal to 2, minus y is equal to 2 minus 3, minus y equal to minus 1, y is equal to 1. So taking x is equal to 3, y is equal to 1. At least 4 points you have to take, 4 values of x you have to take, corresponding values of y you have to find, and you have to make table with those values. These solutions, they will be put in the table, and two values I have told you they are must to put because they will give the better picture of the graph. X zero, y ki value, y zero, then x ki value. Rest of the values of x, it is up to you. Jo bhi aap lena chahte ho. So this way we are making the points that we are going to plot on the graph to get the graph of the given equation. So let us see how. First of all, on the graph paper, you will make two perpendicular axes. As we all know, x-axis, y-axis, this is the origin. Negative side. Arrows are must because these are axes and they are infinite. They can be extended to any side. So you have to put the arrows and origin and x-axis, y-axis. They are to be marked accordingly. Now, the maximum point along x-axis is 3. So, you have 10-10 ke gap pe 1, 2, 3. Aapne likhiye. And as far as y is concerned, it is in the negative direction. So, mujhe thoda sa graph upar karne ko. Taki thoda easy. Y ki value mostly negative hai. This is y dash. So, 0. 1, 2, 3, x axis, y. जितने x की लिखी ना ऊपर लिख लो y. This is नीचे negative लिख लो minus 1, minus 2. Negative side of y axis minus 3. So this way you have written the points on the graph. Now you will plot the points which are with you on the graph. First point is 0, minus 2. So you know how you have plotted the points on the graph in the chapter 3rd coordinate geometry. So starting with the x coordinate, putting the pencil at 0 and goes up to minus 2, this will give you 0 minus 2, mark it to be A. Saath mein naming karte jao, phir joining easy ho jati hai. Agar aap naming kar doge, to joining easy ho jayegi. This is 0 minus 2. Next point is 2, 0. Starting with 2, x 2, y 0. Y 0 means no distance is to be covered. Ye isi pe lie kar jayega. So this will be 2 comma 0. Mark it to be B. Main idhar likh deti hu. This is B, 2 comma 0. Right? Ye point ho gaya B, 2 comma 0. आपको याद होगा, आपको पता है एक्स एक्सिस पे जो पॉइंट लाई करते हैं उनका वाई कोऑर्डिनेट जीरो, सो टू जीरो लाइज ऑन एक्स एक्सिस. देन द पॉइंट इज वन माइनस वन, टेकिंग वन एंड विद माइनस वन, दिस इज सी वन माइनस वन. एंड देन योर लास्ट पॉइंट इज थ्री वन, दिस इज थ्री वन, गोइंग विद थ्री, दिस इज वन. When you will join these points, you will get a graph. इसको आप arrow डाल के आगे लेके जा सकते हो. Scale की help से you will join these points with the help of scale, and you will write on the line, this is x minus y is equal. Right? So this is the way to draw the graph of the linear equation in, you can say, two variables. So what unit, what scale you are taking? Along x-axis, one block is equal to 1 centimeter, and along y-axis also one block represent 1 centimeter. This give you the complete picture of the graph of the linear equation in two variables, x minus y is equal to 2. Right? So rest of the parts you'll do yourself. Let me start with question number second. Second question I'm going to start with, question number six. Let us start with question number second. Second question. Second question is, give the equations of line passing through 240. And how many such lines are possible? We are given a point at 214, and he says, let us find some equations which are passing through these lines, and let us know that how many such lines are there which are passing through the point 214. So let me explain it pehle to isko geometrically. Suppose this is 214 point in the plane. So if I want to draw the line from this point, I can draw infinite many lines which are passing through this point 214. आप देख ही रहे हो, अगर geometrically हम करें तो बहुत सारी straight lines इसमें से pass हो जाएंगी 214 में से. How to write it? Let me tell you. First of all, the question is, give the equations of two lines passing through this point. Very easy to write the equation. I will tell you the method and the trick. You can form so many equations. 214 से pass करने वाली equation. आप x y में कोई expression बोलो जिसमें प्लस माइनस का बीच में साइन हो, एक्स वाई में कोई एक्सप्रेशन, अर्शदीप को एनी एक्सप्रेशन इन एक्स एंड वाई, कैन आई हैव एनी एक्सप्रेशन इन एक्स एंड वाई, अर्शदीप कौर, बच्चे अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ, अर्शदीप, अर्शदीप,
यस मैम,
स्पीक अप, एनी एक्सप्रेशन इन एक्स एंड वाई जो आपका मन करता है. Yes, Ashpreet, you can tell me any algebraic expression in x and y, whatever you like.
5x plus 14y.
थोड़ा easy बता दो, calculations easy हो जाएंगी. कुछ easy.
2x plus 5y.
चलो, she is telling me 2x plus 5. एक तरह से equation को frame करने में अर्शदीप ने मेरी help कर दी. उसने मुझे लेफ्ट हैंड साइड ऑफ द इक्वेशन बता दी. मैंने बनानी है राइट हैंड साइड ऑफ द इक्वेशन. देखना कितनी चलाकी से बनाई है. रफ में ये जो आपका सॉल्यूशन है, पॉइंट है 214, इसको इसमें पुट करो. एक्स की जगह पे 2 एंड वाई की जगह पे 14. आंसर इज 74. सो राइट हैंड साइड विल बी 74. वेरी क्लेवरली वी हैव फॉर्म द राइट हैंड साइड इन सच अ वे such that this 214 becomes the solution of the given equation, because we have to write the equation of which this number is solution, this ordered pair is solution. So left hand side kuch bhi likhi, usme x y ki values ko put kiya, and we are getting the right hand side, and this equation is going to be the equation which is having 214 as solution. ये वैसी ही बात है कि आप कोई गेम खेल रहे हो और आपका कोई खिलाड़ी गेम खेलने आगे जा रहा है, उसकी टर्न है आपकी टीम के किसी प्लेयर की, तो आप बड़े आराम से बैठे हंस रहे हो, लोग पूछते हैं क्यों हंस रहे हो, आप कहते हो कि हमने बॉल को ऐसे चेंज कर दिया है कि हमें पता है कि हमारा प्लेयर ही जीतेगा, ठीक है, हमें पहले ही पता है कि हमारा प्लेयर ही जीतेगा, हमने गड़बड़ कर दी है। आपका कैप्टन जा रहा है टॉस करने कॉइन की, तो आपने दोनों साइड कॉइन को आपने अनफेयर कर दिया, दोनों साइड पे हेड लगा दिया, तो आपका कैप्टन की कॉल है हेड, तो आप हंस रहे हो क्योंकि आपको पता है कि आपके कैप्टन की ही विनिंग विन होगी बिकॉज बोथ साइड हैव हेड। सिमिलरली व्हेन वी आर क्रिएटिंग द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड ऑफ द इक्वेशन एंड पुटिंग दीज वैल्यूज एंड गेटिंग द नंबर एज राइट हैंड साइड, वी नो वेल इन एडवांस दैट दिस विल बी द सॉल्यूशन, क्योंकि इसको पुट करके ही राइट हैंड साइड आई है, तो इस नंबर के लिए ये दोनों साइड्स इक्वल होंगी होंगी, दैट इज फाइनल। चलो और कुछ देखते हैं, और किसी बच्चे से पूछते हैं कोई एल्जेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन इन एक्स वाई। सो लेट मी टेल, लेट मी आस्क फ्रॉम गुरुपाल सिंह, इज वेरी विलिंग टू टेल। हाँ जी गुरुपाल, बता दो आप। गुरुपाल सिंह, यू कैन टेल। यस गुरुपाल सिंह विद हैंडसम डीपी, गुरुपाल सिंह इज देयर ऑन द स्क्रीन विद अस एंड ही इज गोइंग टू टेल वन एक्सप्रेशन इन एक्स एंड वाई। आई थिंक ही इज नॉट एबल टू अनम्यूट हिमसेल्फ। चलिए, सो लेट मी आस्क फ्रॉम गरिमा, गरिमा रोल नंबर 11। गरिमा, कैन आई हैव एन एक्सप्रेशन इन एक्स एंड वाई? चलिए गौरव, यू टेल। गौरव
मैम, माइनस 2x प्लस 7y।
माइनस में क्यों जाना, प्लस वाला कोई बोलो, कैलकुलेशन इजी रहेगी, कुछ भी सिंपल सा।
2x प्लस 5y, ये तो हो ही गया,
ये तो आप कुछ भी बोल दो, x प्लस y ले लो, सबसे आसान x प्लस y लेते हैं हम, देखना कितना इजी हमारा आंसर बन x प्लस y से। मैंने x प्लस y लिया, राइट हैंड साइड आई हैव टू क्रिएट, put a line here, replace x by 2 and y by 14, the answer will be 16. So right hand side is 16. This way I create two such lines which will be passing through to 14, and in this way we can find infinite many number of lines which can pass into 214. Kuch bhi aap x y mein expression lo, if some child is thinking 3x plus y, पुट करो एक्स वाई की वैल्यू, राइट हैंड साइड आ गई। अब कोई बंदा कहता है कि आपको कैसे पता कि ये लाइनें इसमें से पास करेंगी, हमने सेटिंग ही ऐसे कर दी कि वो पास उनको करना ही पड़ेगा, हमने सेटिंग जैसे पॉइंट की थी वैसे इसकी सेटिंग कर दी है, दैट पॉइंट इज डेफिनेटली गोइंग टू पास, राइट। सो द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन एसोसिएटेड विद दिस दिस इज हाउ मेनी मोर सच लाइंस आर देयर एंड व्हाई। चलिए, देयर आर इनफाइनाइट many such lines which passes through 214, because 214 can be the solution of infinite many lines. Infinite many lines इस points में से pass कर सकती हैं 214 में से, reason being 214 बहुत सारी lines का solution बन सकता है, so that's why there are infinite many such lines which passing through 214. Do you able to construct design such lines which are passing through 214? Am I clear about this? Is it okay? चलिए, सो द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 इज, क्वेश्चन नंबर 3, इफ द पॉइंट 3-4 लाइज ऑन द ग्राफ ऑफ द इक्वेशन पी वाई इज इक्वल टू ए एक्स प्लस 7, देन फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ ए, ए की वैल्यू फाइंड करनी है, एस 3-4 lies on the graph of equation number 1, इसको 1 बोल दो, क्योंकि ये ग्राफ पे लाई करता है, तो इसका मतलब इट विल बी डैश ऑफ द इक्वेशन। एनीवन हु कैन फिल दिस ब्लैंक, एज इट लाइज ऑन द ग्राफ देयरफॉर इट विल बी डैश ऑफ द इक्वेशन, कैन मीन
It will be the solution of equation.
It will be the solution of the equation. Therefore, 3, 4 will be the solution of the equation. So put कर दो यहाँ पे solution है तो satisfy करेगा. Y की value 4, x की value 3. Putting y is equal to 4 and x is equal to 3, you are reaching like this. This will be 12 is equal to 3a plus 7. 12 minus 7 is equal to 3a. 5 is equal to 3a. So this implies 5 by 3 is equal to 3. Answer. 5 by 3 is equal to 8 is the answer. So this is all about today's lecture. So many new things we have learned. Hope you have enjoyed the lecture very well. And we'll continue Monday, right? Till then, take care. Bye-bye.